So let us discuss the first example. Here the assembly code is add R5, R6, R7. Okay, so add R5, comma R6, comma R7. Here, what is done here is R6 is added with the R7. Means the content in the R6 is added with the content in the R7. The resultant is stored in the destination register R5. Okay, so here one thing what you have to understand here is, though actually, okay, here first one, what is your RD value? Last video we discussed about, so here what is RD? So let us first write out that one. So here RD is 5, okay, that is RD is of course R5, the R5, the value that is going to be written in the RD field is 5. Now here what will be RN here? RD is the destination register, RN is the first source register. First source register value is 6, okay. So first source register is this is destination register, this is destination register, this is RN, and what is your RM here? RM value will be RM is 7, okay. So this is RM. So this is RD, this is RN, this is RM. So this is RD is 5, RN is 6, then RM is 7. Okay. So now next one, though we write this assembly code add R5 comma R6 comma R7 in the tool, but the assembly what it understands is, that is what we have to know here. It basically understands in this way. Okay. So here add R5 comma R6 comma R7 logical shift left hash 0. This what this does, we have discussed this in the class, hope you remember this one, fine. So what happens here? Here R7 is logical shift lefted by 0, then the resultant is to added with the R6, then this whatever the content that is added with the R6, that will be stored in R5. As you can see here, both these two are equivalent here. There is no difference between these two things. Why? Because R7, when it is logical shift lefted by hash 0, R7 when it is logical shift lefted by hash 0 means what are you doing here? What are you doing here? You are not shifting by any specifically bit amount. Okay. So that's why the R7 content remains same as R7 content. There won't be change in R7. If I have written something 1 or 2, then it would have shifted by 1 or 2 bits. Since whatever the add R5 comma R6 comma R7, assembly converts that one to add R5 comma R6 comma R7 comma logical shift lefted by hash 0. That is basically the way that it does it. Okay, the assembly does that conversion. Now here the logical shift lefted by hash 0, so R7 is logical shift lefted by hash 0, it remains same thing, that is R7 only. So R7 is added with R6, resultant is stored in R5. Okay, so that is in order to fill the instruction set format. So the this conversion is done. This applies to every instruction set also. Whenever you use maybe sub also, sub R5 comma R6 comma R7 also, that time also sub R5 comma R6 comma R7 logical shift left, logical LSL, that is comma hash 0. Okay. So let us discuss about this example. How this is the assembly code that is written. Of course, this assembly code, it is equivalent assembly code. Just bear in mind, this is not a machine code. This is an assembly code. Okay, so this is assembly code that you have written, and this is the equivalent assembly code. This is the equivalent assembly code and ARM assembly code. It is not thumb assembly code. We are discussing about the ARM instruction set. This is equivalent ARM assembly code. Now, this has to be converted to machine code. As we discussed in the last video, basically how much bit is ARM instruction set? It is 32 bit instruction set. As you can see here, I have specified different fields here. As you can see here, this is conditional field. Okay, so this is a conditional field, this is 4 bit conditional field, this is opcode field, immediate value, command, this is status, this is first source register, destination register, shift amount, 5 bit shift amount, this is what kind of shift you are doing, this is default 0, then this is RM, that is second source register. Okay, so let us actually write one by one. Now what is the first that I have written here? 1110. Why I have written 1110? Because I am not using any kind of conditional execution statement. Okay, so what is the value that is always? As we can see here, what is this value that we have it here for the always, means no condition, that is 1110. So that is what you are going to write here, 1110. From 3128 it is 1110. Then what is the value that you are going to put in the opcode field? That is 00. Where you are going to put 00? Because data processing instruction set, default opcode value for the data processing instruction set, be it add, be it subtract, be it logical operations you are doing, those the value that is going to put in opcode field is 00. Then why have written immediate value 0 here? Immediate value 0 because this value I am written add R5 comma R6 comma R7. I am using the last second source field to be register. I am not writing any immediate value here. If I had written immediate value, then what should be written here? I is equal to 1. Then this would have been different. This would have been different as we just observed here. Okay. So see, whenever I is equal to 1 here, you have this operation. Whenever I is equal to 0 here, you have this set of operations. Okay. So now let us come back here. Now, since I is equal to 0, because you have not used any kind of immediate value in the second source field, so that is why I will be equal to 0. Then what is the value that is going to put in the command field? As we discussed in the last video, what is the, it is the add, the value for the add instruction, as you can observe here. Yeah, so here it is there, the mnemonic add. What is the opcode value? The opcode value is 0100. These are all opcode values only. Even this is also an opcode value. Of course, it is OP is written OP field, but this condition also, this also opcode value, this is also opcode value. And what is the value, bit value that you have it for the, yes, of course, for the, sorry, for the add you have 0100. Is it right? Yes, 0100. Now, for this 0100, we are going to write 21 to 24. Whenever we have, when assembly code is asked, we have to convert into machine code, just write the values. Since EQ is not used, it is always, no condition is there. So, 1110. Next, OP, why have written 00? Data processing instruction. Add is a data processing instruction. So, it has to be written 00. Why have written I is equal to 0? Because immediate value is not there. So, that is why 0. Then why is CMD, that is 0100, because that is for the mnemonic add, the opcode value is 0100. Then why is S here 0? Because you have not written add S. Okay, if it was an add S, then S will be 1. Since S you are not updating any flags here, so S will be 0. Then what is this RN? Just remember this one. The first year it is destination register, but whereas first one, what you have to write here, it is the first source field, that is first source field is R6, we have written here. This is what we have to note down here. Okay, this is RN is 6 here. Why I have written 6 means that is the value you are going to write it here, because the R6 value, yeah, R0 to R15. So, you have like 0000 to 1111. So, basically 4 bit that you have it here. That is why it is 16 to 19 4 bit, 12 to 15 4 bit, 0 to 3 4 bit. Now, this is 0100. Why I have written 0110? Because that is the value. That is the value what you have, the binary value for the 6. 0110. Okay. So, here similarly, what is the value that you have it for the, this is the RN, this is the RD field, the destination register field. What is the destination register field that you have here? It is 5. Okay. So, this is what you have, 5 here. So, what is the value that I have written here? 0101. Basically, it is 4 plus 1, 5. This is 4 plus 2, 6. Now comes the point. So, this is R5 is done, R6 is done. So, first we are done with the add. Next, we have done with the R5. Next, we are done with the R6. Now comes the second source field, that is R7. Sorry, R7, yeah, R7. That is RM is 7. Now, we know that there are two kinds of operations we have it here. Whenever we have I is equal to 0. In I is equal to 0, whether we are shifting it by specifying the shift value or we are shifting it by specifying the register. This is what we say, register shifted register. That is, this is only register, because we are shifting it by specifying the value in the shift amount, 5 bit shift amount field, and this we are specifying directly on one more register. Okay. Since for this case, we do not require one more register, we have specified the value, because the assembler equivalent assembly code that you have is logical shift left by hash 0. This is what you have 0. So, this is what you are filling here, shift amount, that is 5 bit shift amount, you are going to write all 5 bit to be 0. because we are not shifting by any kind of we are not shifting by any specific bits here. That we are shifting it by only 0 bit, so it remains the same thing. So logical shift left hash 0, since this is the value that has been written here, so this is 00005 bit, that is the equivalent of this 0. Then what is this sh00? Why I have written 00 here? That is because, as you can see here, for logical shift left, what is the equivalent sh value that you have here? It is 00 logical shift left. Okay, so logical shift left. Now, can we use LSR? You can ask one question, LSR, ASR, ROR. Of course, when you are doing the logical operations, you can do it here, but the assembly does not give that option for this case. For this case, whenever we have add R5, R6, R7, it is always equivalent, it just does this LSL hash 0. It does not do LSR or ASR, it just does LSL hash 0. Got the point here? So, logical shift left hash 0. So, SH is 0, 0. Now, for this, this is default 0, this won't be changed. Then what is this RM? That is 7 I have written here. Why I have written 7 here? The 7 is written here, as you can observe here, because RM is 7 here. So this is what you have 7 here. Okay. So this is what you have 7 here. That's why RM is 7 here. So this is the, so finally, actually, when we club all these things, when we club all these things, we just actually write this one. See, 1110, what is 1110? E. What is 00004? Just actually 4 bits, you make separate feeds. You can just make it like this way, 4 bit, then you have 4 bit. Let me also, okay, one more color here. 4 bit, okay. So when you use this one, see, it is, this is E, this is 0000, so you have 0, then 1000, you have 8. Then 0110, you have 6, 0101, 5, 4 bit zeros, that is you have 0, then you have 0000 again, so you have 0, then 0111, 7. So E0865007, so E0865007. This is the machine code equivalent of assembly code add R5, R6, R7. Okay, so this is how we do it here. So this is the equivalent. So first, what is the thing that you have to do? First, you have to see this one. This only consumes from 20 to 31. Whether conditional is used, no condition. No condition, that's why 1110. Next, data processing instruction 00. No, you have not, then you have to check for this R7, that is you have used immediate value or some register. Since I have used register here, the I value will be 0. Next, you have used 0100. What is the 0100? That is the opcode for this mnemonic add. Then say I have not used add S here, so S field will be 0. So no updation of the status flying. Now comes the register fields, that is the destination register and the source register fields. Now first one is RN, so it is 6 value around, write 0110, the initial write 0101. Next one, the shift amount. So this is the equivalent assembly code that you have. Of course, don't look at this one, you look at this one and write the bit fields here. So this is R, here it is, R5, this is R6, nice, this one is R7, okay. So this is logical shift left hash 0, so you are not shifting by any bit field here, so 000, you just write it that one. Next one, this is the, whether you are doing logical shift left, the LSL, the opcode value is 00. Next one, this is default is 0, last one is 0111, that is this one, the RM value. So RM value is going to be written here. So finally, by clubbing all these things, you get E0865007. Okay, so let us consider one more example. Of course, you can take this one as an assignment also. Just look at this one, example 2. So it is also a very simple case. As you can just observe here also I have taken in the second example, instead of add operation I am doing the subtraction operation. In the subtraction operation, basically SUB R8 R9 R10, of course, okay. So R8, so you can just observe here what this will be converted. Maybe let me discuss here only. So this one will be converted, equivalent assembly code is sub, let me write R8 comma R9 comma R10 comma, then what do you have, logical shift left hash 0. Okay, so logical shift left hash 0. So this is the equivalent assembly code you have here. So subtract R8, R9, R10 comma logical shift left by hash 0. Here R10 is logical shift left by hash 0, so it remains the same thing, that is added with R9 and resultant is stored in the R8. Okay, so this is what you get here. So after you get this one, then I think you can write this 32-bit machine code. It is same as that one. Let me actually discuss here only. So what do we have here? So this is subtract operation. Since we are not using any kind of so let me look at this one. Subtract operation, we are not using any condition here. So no EQ or any like that way. So that's why you are using always condition. You have this 1110. So after having 1110, next one, what is the RDE value in this one? So let me write it here. Okay, before actually first you write that one only. So first is RDE, what is the value? That is 8. And what is the value that you have for R9? Sorry, RN is, what do we have, 9 here. Then you have RM is 10. Okay, so now let me take this one. Okay, so here while button 00 data processing instruction, this is the always condition, data processing instruction 00. Since I have used the register here RM, it is not immediate value, I is 0 here. What is 0010? Yeah, this is for the subtract operation. As you can just look at this one, subtract mnemonic, what is the value that you have here? 0010. Okay, for add you had 0100, no, 0010 is for subtract. Now 0010, why is this yes? Because I am not doing any kind of updating the status flag here. So SUB yes, if you do, then S should be 1 here. Since you have written SUB, what will be the S value? S value will be 0, S field will be 0, that is a better way. Now what is this RN? RN, why I have written 9? Because RN is 9 here. And what is this RD 8? 8 is this one. This is RD field, RN field, RD field. Shift amount is 5 bit, that is you have 0 here, those, that's why 0 here. Then why I have written 00 here? That is shift, because I am doing the logical shift left. So logical shift left, what do you have here is 00. Okay. So then what do you have 0? This is 0. By default it is 0 only, 4th bit. Now what is this 1010? 1010 is your RM. Okay. So what this is RM value, that is 10. This is second source field. Okay. So that is first source field, second source field. R9 first source field, R10 second source field, both are added, then the destination is R8. So this is how it is written. So it is same as the previous example. So finally you have to club this one. So what you do, you just take it 4 by 4. So 4, then you have this 4. Maybe let me take another color, that is mentor. Okay, it is. Now this one is 1001 1000, 4 bit. Then you have another 4 bit, this one. So if you just write this one equivalent, you get it like this. That is E0 0100. Okay, you can just observe here 0100 is 4, then 1001 is 9, 100 is 8, then you have the 0, then you have the 0, 1010 is A. So this is the equivalent machine code for the assembly code subtract R8, R9, R10. You are going to write subtract R8, R9, R10, but your machine understands this E0498000A, then later what operation has to perform, then that will be done. So machine code equivalent of this assembly code for this assembly code. Hope you understood this one. Okay, thank you.